I don't need your money. I want your life. And I hear you say that I'm coming.
Hey, everybody. It's getting colder out, as you can tell, because I'm wearing my flannels. And so I had to pull them from the back of the closet and put them towards the front. But it's not cold enough to where I have to wear a full jacket, so I'm excited about that. Well, I like the fall, and I enjoy the changing in the seasons and when the leaves are kind of falling, and I know that you all do too. So anyways, today we're going to be studying Sarah. And before I go there, though, did you recognize the song that was playing right in the front of the video called To Obey Is Better Than Sacrifice? Do you remember that song? Well, that was back in the 70s and early 80s. Keith Green had written that song and performed it, and it's one of my favorite songs. And of course, if you know anything about Keith Green, he died in 1982. Just 20 seconds after his airplane took off, him and his two children and the pilot and the entire Smalley family, which there was six in their family. Super sad situation. But, you know, he left behind some great music. And if you have forgotten about that, go on and listen to some of his music. It's really super good, and I enjoy it. So today we're going to talk about how it is better to obey than sacrifice. And Sarah and Abraham and all them, they didn't always obey God. And in fact, sometimes they laughed at God. And so we're going to find that out today as we study Sarah. We've already studied Abraham. We've already studied their son Isaac and Abraham's illegitimate child, whatever you want to call him, Ishmael. So we're going to talk about Sarah today, okay? Sarah is the Hebrew word, and it shows up here, and it means lady, princess, or noble woman. And she was really a follower of God. She really was. But she, just like all of us, has doubted God in her lifetime, has disobeyed God in her lifetime, has done some things in her lifetime that mirror us, okay? So we can't jump too hard on Sarah, because anything she ever did, we've done twice as bad, okay? She was born around 1986 BC, okay? And lived for 127 years, according to Genesis chapter 23, verse 1. And actually said she lived 127 years. Pretty cool. She was from Ur, the land of the Chaldeans. So do you know anything about the Chaldeans? Now, I've got a map here showing exactly with the black line where it's actually located. And you can see it's just a little west and north of the Persian Gulf. And it's in the Babylonian region, okay? And these people were actually pagans, okay? They weren't God-fearing people, all right? They lived in the southern Babylonian area, which would have been the southern part of Iraq today. And sometimes the term Chaldeans is used to refer to Babylonians, and in general, but normally it really refers to a specific semi-nomadic type people or tribe that lived in the southern part of Babylon. Okay, so they were really their own people, all right? And we're just kind of taking a little deviation to give you kind of an idea of where Sarah actually came from. But I love to dig into these things. I like to understand where people came from in the Bible times, because then it gives me a little bit of a different perspective and understanding than just exactly what the Bible says. You know, I enjoy finding out where they were actually from, how their culture was, okay? And so there's nothing wrong with taking the Bible and then expanding on, okay, this person was Chaldean. Well, let's find out a little bit about what Chaldeans were, okay? Because sometimes the Bible doesn't explain exactly who, you know, somebody is from their culture sometimes. So it's okay to venture out and find out, and as long as you come back around to the Word of God, all right? The Chaldeans, they were very intelligent people, sometimes very aggressive. They were warlike people, you know, not warlocks. They did worship pagans, but they were pagans, but they were warlike people. They liked to go to war. They were aggressive sometimes. The Chaldeans actually influenced Nebuchadnezzar to make the decision to throw Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego into the fire. And you can read about that in Daniel chapter 3, verses 8 through 12. And, anyways, that's those kind of people. And that's kind of where Sarah came from. And that was her people. And so let's come back around to who Sarah was and what was going on with her. She was actually a very beautiful woman. And according to Genesis chapter 12, verse 11, she was actually the half-sister of her husband, Abraham. Okay? Kind of gross, right? Had the... if you want to go to Genesis, actually chapter 20 and 12, it says, and his wife according to. So let's kind of dig into that a little bit here. In verse 12, it says, but indeed, she is truly my sister. She is the daughter of my father, but not the daughter of my mother. Okay. So a sister from another mother, or like a brother from another mother type thing. Had the same dad, but had a different mother, all right? And she became my wife. That's what the scripture says. They had the same father, which was Terah, T-E-H-A-R, but different mothers, okay? In those days, marrying half-sisters wasn't really considered a bad thing according to society. But God never liked it. In fact, and if you look in Deuteronomy chapter 27, verse 22, okay, it says that cursed is the one who lies with his sister, the daughter of his father, or the daughter of his mother. Okay, so God was still not okay with incest. He never was. Okay, it just sometimes, like in Adam and Eve time, kind of had to happen. But by this time, by the time Abraham come around and all the other people that had come, there was far enough removed that God was serious about this stuff. In fact, he put it in Deuteronomy. I don't like it. Don't do it. But yet he did. Okay. So what does this mean? Abraham was not above sinning. And he knew God didn't want it, didn't like it. Okay. And as you can tell, later on, this kind of gets them in a little bit of trouble. When Sarah and Abraham were traveling, they had hid the fact that they were married. All right. They kind of told a half truth here. If you look in Genesis chapter 12, verse 17, it says, but the Lord plagued Pharaoh and his house with great plagues because Sarah, Abraham's wife, verse 18, and Pharaoh called Abram, and said, what is this you have done to me? Why did you not tell me she was your wife? So God had plagued what was going on here because, and I didn't think that was ever very fair, but, far be it from me to ever, tell God what I think what he did was fair or not. Now, I'm never going to do that, okay? But what I did understand here in verse 20, he had done the same thing. He told the half-truth, okay? In chapter 20, verse 3, it says, but God came to Amalek in a dream by night and said to him, indeed, you are a dead man. I love this part. Because of a woman whom you have taken, for she is a man's wife. Now, Amalek didn't understand. He told God that he had no idea. And God said in verse 7, now therefore restore the man's wife, for he is a prophet, and he will pray for you, and you shall live. But if you don't restore her, know that you shall surely die. Or know that, yeah, you shall surely die. And you are you and all who are yours. So God said, if you don't fix this, I'm gonna kill you. You're a dead man. So he, Amalek gave him back real quick. So as they were traveling, Abraham and Sarah did this twice. Okay, so we know that Sarah was barren, and of course this caused her stress, because if you know anything about this timeline and in the Bible days, this was a cultural. Am I saying it? Shame to a woman that couldn't bear children. Okay, it was looked as shameful. And Abraham worried that he would not have any offspring, and so, or an heir. And God had promised they would have children. God promised this. And so Sarah had gotten impatient, and what she had done is she had given her servant Hagar, which we'd already studied about Hagar as well. You kind of know the story about this if you've been watching my videos, that so that she could have a son, so that Abram wouldn't suffer. And his name was Ishmael. We talked about Ishmael, and he was about 14 years older than their son Isaac. And there were some issues there. Because of sin, there's always going to be issues, okay? Well, God had changed Sarah's name in Genesis 17:15, which means mother of nations. So he dropped the I and added the H, and she became the mother of nations. And but God still honored his promise to give her a son. And she was 90 according to Genesis chapter 17, verse 17. So all women are watching this show right now. Let me just say, if you're not 90 years old yet, you still have a chance, okay? All right? And at first, and you're laughing, you're probably laughing just like Sarah did, because in Genesis 18, verses 9 through 15, when the discussion was going on, it says she laughed when she heard it. So she laughed at God. This showed disrespect to the Lord, because he loved her. He loved Abraham, and he wanted to give them a son. And so, bottom line, what happened? We understand that they had a child at a very old age, and, you know, 99, I think, 99 and 100 years old when they had Isaac. And but despite her disobedience, she's known as a faithful person, and you can find this out in Hebrews 11:11 and Peter 1, 1 Peter, excuse me, 3, 5 through 6. If you're a person who only reads the New Testament, there's proof right there that she was a very faithful person. So what's the better? Obedience. Obedience is better. And they did have a very wonderful son. In fact, Abraham loved him so much that God wanted to test his faith. Remember that? So anyways, kind of a quick video. I just wanted you to kind of get a feel for who Sarah was. And I hope that you will dig a little bit deeper into this. Like when I first saw a little expert on Sarah, I decided to dig a little deeper, find out where she was from, and have fun with it. Have fun pulling up some history about these people. That's what I kind of did. So, okay, you guys have a great day, and we'll talk to you soon.
Hearts of fire, not your prayers of ice, and I'm coming quickly.